Bonjour monsieur et madame, it is me le chef Reddit, today I have a special ala Reddit for you. Bon appétit and remember to subscribe.
What's something that you like, but hate the fan base? Reddit culture can be annoying to me a lot of times. Reddit. Doctor Who and Sherlock. I used to really casually enjoy these things, but the amount of weirdness around people who are obsessed with the two of these things, turned me off of it quite a bit. Rick and Morty. I love the show but some of the fans are really weird. Magic the Gathering. The stigmas behind what people imagine a Magic player to be bothers me. The general player probably hates something in the game one genuinely enjoy, and the people I've played with outside my family have ruined me wanting to support my local game store because I don't want to deal with the other people that play. Masturbation. I enjoy a good old wank as much as anyone, but the real enthusiasts who collect the memorabilia and go to all the conventions just give me the creeps. If you spend enough time in a fanbase eventually you'll hate it, so all of them. The Nightmare Before Christmas, and other Tim Burton-esque films. This fanbase was larger back in the early 2000s when the emo platforms of old were prolific with fanfic, posts and badly drawn art and low-res screenshots pasted with animated glitter love heart stickers. Nowadays it's not so prominently featured on social medias, but I know more than a fair few full-grown adults that still fawn over Jack Skellington and Sally in the most cringe-worthy ways. Weirdly enough for me it's the WWE. Especially with Raw and SmackDown right now. It seems that majority of the fan base want everyone to be over and no one to be over at the same time. I really just want to watch some super freak humans throw each other through tables. That's what I'm about. 21 Pilots plus Rick and Morty oof. Beyoncé. I think her music is good and she is a very talented singer, but her fan base, the Beehive, is way too rabid. Tom Holland. I don't hate the fan base, but some fans are a bit creepy. I like Tom Holland's acting, he's a good actor, and I am a fan, but sometimes I get creeped out by his fans. Like I'll make an occasional joke but talking about him constantly is kind of creepy. Or following him around and taking pictures of him, when you're not paparazzi, and constantly knowing where he is? Like that's super stalker why. I know that he's a young actor that's in a lot of popular movies, but don't stalk him. It's straight up creepy. Now I'm a target for a bunch of pre-teen teenage girls. Fun. Nirvana. Not the whole fanbase, but primarily the ones who say you have to hate the popular songs and love the low-key ones, as well as the ones who talk about it like they're the last good band to ever exist. The ones who glorify Cobain's suicide also get on my nerves. Everything. People are real good at ruining everything. It amazes me how almost any fanbase will have a toxic side. Even just scrolling through the Instagram of a singer or actor I like, it's full of self-proclaimed fans being incredibly rude to the person they're a fan of. Like this person will post a picture of them traveling or being with friends and family, and the comments are full of criticism towards their appearance or lifestyle, or some will straight up say, "We don't care, we want a new album." Like, let them live. You're supposed to be a fan. Really makes me wonder what these people are like in real life, and how they treat their friends and family. FRIENDS. Some of the fans consider it the pinnacle of TV shows and some of them just go berserk on people who don't share their opinion. Homestuck and Undertale. They've definitely gotten better, but I was into those too when the fanbase had reached its worst. I actually really like CW shows. I know they're stupid and they're completely unrealistic, over the top, and obnoxious, but they are so good for just escaping reality. The fans drive me nuts. It's a TV show, not a cult. Let's just enjoy it and move on. Harry Potter. I said this before but I loved the books and movies growing up and they were a big part of my youth, but the community can be pretty intense, especially when they're treating houses like they are zodiac signs. Edit, I don't know where a lot of you are getting that I think zodiac signs mean anything, I'm just using that as an example of the extremes of the fandom. Undertale and Deltarune. Both are fantastic games. But I can only take so many comic fandubs, AMVs, fan-made spin-offs, and crack pairings until I want to foist a tomahawk through my primary motor cortex. R. Ascredit. Marijuana. Edit, there's a couple of them in this thread. K-pop. A few years ago, my friends introduced it to me and I thought the music wasn't terrible, so I slowly became a fan of random music from different groups. Many fans of these K-pop groups are toxic and like to start fan wars with other groups. It's way too much drama, but I'm not trying to go against all the fans. It's just that some of these PPL are way too obsessed. The band Tool. Their fans are called Toolabands for a reason. League of Legend. Seriously, can't get a game without someone flaming. Most anime. I'm not sure if this counts, but Tesla. I love their technology and what they are doing for the automotive sector, but they are not without fault. But don't tell that to their hardcore fans. Edit, be still, my beating inbox. Some of the anti-Tesla comments are just as insane as the Tesla cultist comments. What happened to balance? K-pop. Not all, but I know so many MCU fans who are cringy AF. Just can't stand the posts they spam. I love the movies though. Hamilton. Anime. Every time I find one that I like, I mention it to other people and then they feel the need to shit on whatever I'm watching and say I should watch something else because it's better. Undertale. Edit, thanks for my first silver edit too, thanks for my first gold. Supernatural. Great show with likable characters, but it seems like all the people that watch it are wannabe emo or the kids that weren't cool enough to join the anime groups. The Teachings of Jesus. The band Queen. On any YouTube video where anyone discusses a band or song they like that's not Queen, there will be comments about how Queen is the best band, and how Freddie Mercury is a messiah or a god, and how every other singer should blow him. And when someone discusses a Queen song and expresses criticism, there are fans who act like it's a personal attack on them and get way too defensive. They're just annoying. I like Apple products, but I hate hearing over excessive praise or hate for them. This is just a computer, phone, whatever I like, just let me use it in peace, goddamn. Edit, thank you for my first ever award, Anon. Steven Universe. The show is pretty great, art, Steven Universe is great. The fanbase as a whole isn't great. RWBY. RWBY can be hell on earth. National parks. Most of the people who go there are loud, obnoxious, litter everywhere, demand special treatment, act like idiots, get a picture of me between the mama bear and her cubs. I'm going to pet that moose. Look. A buffalo. I'm going to slam on the brakes. They whine so much they had to put cell towers in the back country of Yellowstone because too many people were whining that they couldn't post selfies to Instagram. BTS, some people just can't go 1 minute without bringing it up. Not a 100% overlap with the entire community, but I write on the SCP Foundation and I avoid the forums and IRC unless I need feedback on a draft because there is considerable drama. I met a moderator once in real life and she said that it was probably way healthier the way I contribute. Being vegan. Other vegans are fucking insufferable. Some people have pointed to specific games, but I'm just gonna say, gaming in general. I've been into video games my entire life, 34, but gamers contain a large mixture of antisocial, cringy, and borderline toxic personalities. One of the things I've hated for as long as it's been a thing, is online gaming, the language used, the negativity, the hyperbolically overaggressive nature, the sore losers asterisk and asterisk sore winners, generally, unironically, worse than the losers. It's all just too much. I unsubscribed from the gaming subreddit after little more than a month, because for every good, funny thing that gets posted there, that makes it to the front page, there's 100 posts bitching about one thing or another. Everyone's either a perfect score critic, a professional that could have done it better themselves, or an edgy 12-year-old trying to say rape and the N-word as many times as possible. It's fucking exhaustively draining. Hunting and guns. And #X200B. I was taught a respectful way of hunting. That a kill should be as instantaneous as possible as a matter of decency and skill, that one should not take more than they need, that one should be grateful for the life taken, etc. From a modern perspective, I consider an animal that has grown to adulthood roaming natural forests and marshes to have had a better life than a factory-farmed animal. I also just like living off the land and being in tune with my local wilderness and weather. And #X200B. However, it is impossible to be socially involved in the community without getting into some prejudicial NRA politics within the first 10 minutes of any conversation. Reggae music. Can a guy like reggae without being associated with stoners? The fan base completely ruined FNAF for me. I like the games themselves, but my goodness, is the fan base bad. Undertale has a pretty nasty one too that I am guilty of being part of in the past. I'll forever love that game, but the fan base is the worst. Edit, that's a lot of upvotes. Edit 2, I will say one thing completely was an overstatement. The hidden story is always interesting. Joe Rogan's podcast. The Lakers. There are idiots in any fan base, but there are just so many Laker fans that by volume, there are more loud idiots than pretty much every other fan base. I'm proud of the fact I'm gay. But it seems like the LGBT community is hell-bent on shaming everyone who doesn't agree with them politically. It's become kind of toxic emo. Billie Eilish. Her music is great, but 90% of her fans are Fjällräven-wielding, TikTok-obsessed 14-year-old girls. Having celiac disease. Everyone these days is gluten-free, intolerant, and it makes me look like a tool because I need special meals or instruction to not get sick while everyone else does it just cause they're picky or just because they can. Almost any popular YouTuber ever. There's always creepy fans who make fan fiction or something.
Thank you for watching. What was your favorite answer? Do you have a better one? Comment it down below. Au revoir.